That state of total dissolution of identity. You want that state because it's a state where you don't feel the pain of the body and the pain of the reality of life. And this teaching says, no, beta, ye mat karo, idhar raho, stay here, do not go into that state, do not allow the hankering after that state. And in that context, I asked you, if you're yearning for dissolution of identity, who is that thing that is yearning for it? What is the I that is yearning for it? Who is that I? What is that I?
That is again ego, which is saying I know. So,
and if, is that I called Mohit or is that I called Lino? What is the name of that I that is yearning for that? From which mouth did that word I come out?
This body.
What is the name of this body? It has a name, right? It has an Aadhaar card number also.
That space was nameless, that if I'm able to convey it here.
I mean, you have a mouth, you have a tongue, there's a name to this body that's speaking. Isn't that name Mohit? No?
Yeah.
Without the body, you can't speak, right? You can't even say the word I. Without the body, can you speak?
No, I cannot. Yeah, I cannot. Yeah, yeah.
So then the body is speaking, right?
Yeah, yeah.
The body has a name. It was born somewhere.
Yeah.
It has a mother.
Yeah.
So you can't deny these three facts. Because the name is given at birth, so it sticks to you. Okay, you can even throw away the name, but can you throw away the mother? From whose body you came, it's a fact. It has been witnessed by many people.
Right.
So you can't deny that fact.
Right.
So that is taken as that minimal identity, that which is undeniable by any conceptual exercise. No conceptual exercise can deny the I-ness of the body.